This is OCAMA-TV. He is the former CMO of Kodak turned global business consultant and best-selling author Jeffrey Haislip. His new book, Running the Gauntlet, spurs on marketers and business leaders to act as agents of change.
I think a thing for most agents of change is to really be good listeners. In fact, a number of years ago at Fortune 100 company, I termed the term chief listening officer, someone to act like an air traffic controller in the operation. In a small business, by the way, you're the CEO and the chief bottle washer and the chief listening officer. In larger companies, you might have the luxury of being able to have somebody who can listen to these conversations, but it's imperative for a leader to be a great listener. And by being a great listener, you can really act on what your customers are wanting, where you want to go, and make sure that you can change and help to impact the mood in your company and deliver on those promises. The other thing I think it's important for leaders to do is make it a lot nicer to where you're going to go than where you've been. And I give this example as I have a horse by the name of Jay. In fact, my horses are named A, B, C, D, and this one happens to be Jay, or I like to nickname this one Glue, because he's a real pain in the rear end. And when I want to get my horse to go in a trailer, because I'm going to go out in the ranch and I'm going to ride the fences or do something way off, and I need to get him there by trailer rather than ride 20, 30 miles, then what I want to do is get them into a trailer. And a horse's natural inclination is to run, to flee. That's how they survive for many years. They think someone's going to eat them. So when you try to force them into a small, confined space, they don't want to go. And my horses are fairly wild because they don't get ridden very much, obviously because I name them A, B, C, D, and so forth. But this particular horse, when I take him to the trailer, he balks, doesn't want to go in. And I have to talk to him very nicely. You know, Jay, let's go in the trailer. There's oats there. There's corn there. It's going to be nice. You're going for a ride. It's going to be pleasant. And then I back him away, and then I take a switch and I switch at him, and I start yelling like, yeah, and I get crazy and I make him run around and I irritate him and bug him, and then I take him back to the trailer and talk nice and say, we're going to go for a ride, there's going to be corn, there's going to be oats, there's going to be a nice place, Jay, it's going to be beautiful. And then I back him up and I do it again, back and forth, irritating over here until nice over here. And by the time the last three or four times, I take him from the irritating place, I take him up to the trailer, he runs right in, because he knows that's a safer place to be. And that's what we need to do in our business, is we need to make it more irritating, the places that we have been, or where we don't want to be, to the places we want to be. And so we have to make it a lot nicer. And by the way, let me give you one more piece of advice. Act like a Viking and burn the boats. So burn the boats so that nobody can ever run back to the old place, and burn them as fast as you possibly can. Have a big bonfire.
This is OCAMA-TV, the JSP Creative Production, in association with the Orange County Chapter of American Marketing Association.